Dawn breaks over the African savanna as a small group of early humans stirs beneath the canopy of an ancient baobab tree. No limestone cliffs tower overhead. No protective cave mouths offer sanctuary from the elements. Yet these humans have thrived here for generations, creating ingenious shelters from nothing but what nature provides. The popular image of our ancestors huddled in dark caves barely scratches the surface of human ingenuity. So what did our species do for the millions of years before we found caves? And how did they create homes from thin air? When we think of prehistoric humans, the image that comes to mind is almost always the same. Fur-clad figures crouched around fires in the mouths of caves, the flickering light dancing on rough stone walls. This caveman stereotype is so deeply embedded in our culture that we rarely question it. But here's the shocking truth. Caves suitable for human habitation were incredibly rare. And for most of human history, our ancestors lived completely in the open. The evidence is written in stone, quite literally. Archaeological sites across Africa, where human evolution began, tell a radically different story than the cave-dwelling narrative. At Olduvai Gorge in Tanzania, where some of our earliest ancestors lived 2 million years ago, researchers have found extensive evidence of human occupation with virtually no caves in sight. Instead, they've uncovered something far more remarkable: the remains of the world's first constructed shelters. The story begins with Homo habilis, our earliest tool-making ancestors. Living on the open plains of East Africa, these early humans faced a challenge that would define our species: how to create protection where none naturally existed. The solution they developed was elegantly simple, yet revolutionary. Using nothing but stones and branches, they created the first artificial shelters in human history. At sites like DK1 in Olduvai Gorge, archaeologists Mary and Louis Leakey uncovered circular arrangements of stones dating to 1.8 million years ago. These weren't random scatters, but carefully placed foundations for temporary shelters. The stones, some weighing over 30 pounds, had been deliberately transported from distant locations and arranged in oval patterns roughly 12 feet across. Analysis of the site revealed that these stone circles once anchored simple windbreaks made from thorny acacia branches. But this was just the beginning. As our ancestors spread across the globe, they encountered environments where even basic materials were scarce. In the windswept grasslands of Eurasia, early humans developed techniques that would make a modern survival expert proud. They learned to read the landscape like a book, identifying subtle depressions that could be enhanced into sleeping areas and recognizing which tree species provided the most durable framework materials. One of the most ingenious solutions came from the humans who first ventured into forested regions. Archaeological evidence from sites like Bilzingsleben in Germany, dating to 400,000 years ago, reveals something extraordinary: tree platform shelters. Working with primitive stone tools, these early humans carefully selected living trees with suitable branch configurations, then modified them to create elevated sleeping platforms safe from ground predators and flooding. The engineering behind these arboreal shelters was remarkably sophisticated. Analysis of tool marks on preserved wooden artifacts shows that these early architects understood weight distribution, choosing branches capable of supporting multiple adults while maintaining the tree's health. They wove smaller branches into sleeping mats and created lean-to roofs using broad leaves and bark sheets, secured with plant fiber cordage that they twisted by hand. But perhaps the most impressive pre-cave technology emerged in regions where even trees were scarce. On the steppes of Central Asia, where early humans encountered vast grasslands broken only by occasional rock outcroppings, our ancestors became master earthworkers. At Kostroma in Russia, archaeologists have uncovered evidence of underground sleeping chambers dating to 800,000 years ago. These weren't simple holes in the ground, but carefully engineered subterranean shelters. Using wooden digging sticks and flat stones as shovels, early humans excavated oval chambers up to 6 feet deep and 10 feet across. The excavated earth was piled around the perimeter, to create windbreaks, while the interior walls were lined with grass and hide to prevent cave-ins. Overhead, a framework of bent saplings supported a roof of woven grass mats that could be quickly removed for entry and exit. The sophistication of these early shelters extended beyond mere protection from the elements. At Gesher Benot Yaakov in Israel, dating to 750,000 years ago, researchers discovered evidence of specialized shelter zones within early human camps. Different areas were designated for sleeping, tool making, food preparation, and waste disposal. The first examples of organized domestic architecture in human history. Water management was another crucial innovation. Early humans living in open environments couldn't rely on cave formations to channel rainwater, so they developed their own drainage systems. Excavations at Terra Amata in France, dating to 400,000 years ago, reveal carefully dug channels around shelter sites designed to divert rainwater away from living areas. Some sites even show evidence of elevated sleeping platforms that kept occupants dry during seasonal flooding. The materials used in these early shelters reveal the incredible resourcefulness of our ancestors. In coastal regions, early humans collected driftwood and seaweed to create dome-shaped huts anchored with stones and shells. In desert areas, they learned to identify and harvest the few available resources: date palm fronds for roofing, dried grass for insulation, and clay-rich soil for waterproofing. One of the most remarkable discoveries came from the Caucasus Mountains, where researchers uncovered a 1.8 million-year-old site that completely revolutionized our understanding of early human architecture. At Dmanisi in Georgia, archaeologists found evidence of semi-permanent settlements that our ancestors returned to season after season. These early humans had created a standardized shelter design that could be quickly assembled and disassembled as needed. The Dmanisi shelters used a brilliant modular system. Standardized wooden poles were cut to specific lengths and stored in underground caches. When the group returned to the site, these poles could be quickly assembled into framework structures using pre-dug post holes. Hide covers, also stored in underground pits, could then be stretched over the framework to create weather-tight shelters in a matter of hours. This system reveals something profound about early human cognition. Our ancestors weren't just reacting to immediate shelter needs, but engaging in complex long-term planning. They were thinking seasonally, even annually, preparing for future needs and developing standardized solutions that could be replicated across different locations. The transition from these open-air shelters to cave occupation happened gradually and wasn't universal. Even after humans began using caves in some regions, many groups continued to prefer constructed shelters. The reasons were practical. Caves were often damp, poorly ventilated, and occupied by dangerous predators. Many were located far from water sources or good hunting grounds. In contrast, constructed shelters could be built exactly where they were needed. Archaeological evidence shows that early humans often modified natural shelters when they found them. At Kesem Cave in Israel, dating to 400,000 years ago, researchers discovered that early inhabitants had extensively modified the cave interior, creating artificial walls, elevated sleeping areas, and specialized activity zones. They weren't simply accepting what nature provided, but adapting it to their specific needs. The technology of pre-cave shelter construction required specialized knowledge that was passed down through generations. Experiments by modern archaeologists have shown that building effective shelters using only stone tools and natural materials requires extensive understanding of local ecology, seasonal patterns, and construction techniques. This knowledge had to be maintained and transmitted across generations, creating some of humanity's first technological traditions. Tool marks on preserved wooden artifacts reveal that different groups developed distinct construction techniques adapted to their local environments. Groups living in bamboo forests developed different lashing techniques than those in deciduous woodlands. Coastal peoples created different water-resistant treatments than inland groups. These regional variations represent some of the earliest examples of human cultural diversity. The social implications of pre-cave shelter construction were profound. Building substantial shelters required cooperation and coordination among group members. Archaeological evidence suggests that shelter construction was often a community activity, with different individuals contributing specialised skills. This cooperation may have been one of the driving forces behind the development of complex human social structures. Evidence from sites like Schöningen in Germany, dating to 400,000 years ago, shows that shelter construction sites were also centres for tool manufacturing, food processing, and social interaction. The act of building homes together helped create the social bonds that would become fundamental to human civilization. The abandonment of constructed shelters in favour of caves where it occurred often coincided with climate changes that made open-air living more challenging. During ice ages, when temperatures dropped and resources became scarce, the energy savings of using natural shelters became more important than their disadvantages. But even during these periods, many human groups continued to enhance cave environments with constructed elements. Perhaps most remarkably, many of the techniques developed by our pre-cave ancestors continued to be used long after cave dwelling became common. Indigenous peoples around the world maintain sophisticated shelter building traditions that trace their origins back millions of years. The dome-shaped structures of Arctic peoples, the elevated platforms of tropical forest dwellers, and the underground homes of desert peoples all echo techniques first developed in humanity's earliest days. Modern survival experts studying these ancient techniques are often amazed by their effectiveness. Military survival training programs now teach methods that were first developed by early humans living without any tools beyond shaped stones and pointed sticks. The fundamental principles, understanding local materials, working with natural forces rather than against them, and creating modular systems that can be quickly assembled, remain as relevant today as they were 2 million years ago. The story of pre-cave human shelters is ultimately a story of innovation born from necessity. Faced with the challenge of survival in open environments, our ancestors didn't wait for nature to provide solutions. They created their own, developing technologies and techniques that laid the foundation for all subsequent human architecture. When we look at the archaeological record with fresh eyes, we see not primitive cave dwellers, but ingenious engineers who solved complex problems with simple tools. They were the first architects, the first city planners, the first engineers. Their innovations, from underground chambers to elevated platforms to modular construction systems, established principles that continue to influence how we build homes today. The next time you see a homeless shelter made from tarps and shopping carts, or a disaster relief structure assembled from prefabricated components, remember that you're looking at techniques first developed by humans who had nothing but stones and sticks. The ingenuity that allowed our species to thrive in environments where we had no natural advantages continues to serve us today, reminding us that the greatest shelter technology of all is the human capacity for innovation.